Gonna go do a full walkthrough of my $50,000 Hot Wheels studio. I've got a ton of stuff to show you guys. I know this video is long overdue. I've had a lot of people asking me, do a Hot Wheels studio tour, show us everything that you have, show us all your filming gear, everything. So we're gonna go over all of that stuff in today's video. Thank you very much for joining in. If you are just joining in, please smash that thumbs up button. That really helps me out, helps those YouTube algorithms. Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it. But let's go ahead and start off by answering a few questions that I get. I get a lot of questions from you guys about how much is my Hot Wheels collection worth? How many Hot Wheels do I have? How long I've been doing YouTube? Stuff like that. So let's go over a couple of those questions first before we get into the full tour. So how much is my Hot Wheels collection worth? This is something I get all the time. It's really hard to put a price on my collection. I've got a lot of newer stuff. I don't have a lot of older stuff, but I do collect some rare stuff, some super treasure hunts, stuff like that. You can see in the background my tracks, all different types of setup and stuff that I have. So how much is it worth? It's really impossible to put a price on something like that. But if somebody offered me, say, $25,000 just for my Hot Wheels, I probably wouldn't sell them. I probably wouldn't sell them. They're worth more than me than that. They're worth, because obviously you guys know I do YouTube. It's one of my main sources of income. So I do make money off of all of my cars and stuff that I have. So I wouldn't sell them. They are part of my business. They're part of my collection. I truly love them. They're my collection. They're just awesome. So I would never sell my Hot Wheels cars if somebody offered me $25,000, $50,000, I wouldn't sell them. Sorry guys, they're not for sale. I get a lot of questions. Are your Hot Wheels for sale? Can you sell me a Bugatti? Blah, blah, blah. No, sorry guys, my Hot Wheels are not for sale. Next question is, how many Hot Wheels do I have? That's another question I don't know the exact number of. I get new Hot Wheels all the time. You guys can see I've got bins full of Hot Wheels. There's storage bins below all of everything, all the black stuff that you see there, all the black table and stuff like that. There's storage bins and stuff. I have tons of different Hot Wheels. I've never put the time in to actually count the exact number of Hot Wheels that I have. But if I were to estimate, I'd probably over 10,000 Hot Wheels that I actually own myself. So yeah, another question, what was one of my first Hot Wheels? One of my first Hot Wheels cars was actually a black 32 Ford that had flames on it. And I have it somewhere here. I don't know exactly where it is. It's somewhere here, but that was, from what I can remember, that was my first Hot Wheels. How long have I been collecting Hot Wheels? Literally for as long as I can remember, probably since I was about 4 to 5 years old. Hot Wheels have always been part of my collection. I've just been collecting and collecting, collecting. I collected from, I've actually even in 1998, I know I'm probably older than most of you guys, I'm aging myself here. In 1998, I actually went to India and I bought Ferrari F50s in India. So I have Hot Wheels from all around the world. So yeah, so I've been collecting for a long time, long before I started doing YouTube. And I started doing YouTube as kind of a hobby. I never intended to be peak time racing, have a Hot Wheels studio just like this, and have a ton of different Hot Wheels to show you guys all the time. I never intended to do that. It's just part of my love and part of my collection, and I still collect. And even though I do YouTube now as a business, I am still a collector of Hot Wheels. So I absolutely love them. Even if I didn't do YouTube, I would still collect Hot Wheels. I just can't get enough of them, guys. The other question is, how long have I been doing YouTube? So on my peak time racing channel, is probably only about 4 to 5 years old. But actually doing YouTube, I actually started my first YouTube channel in about 2006, 2007. So I've been on YouTube a long time. I have lots of different YouTube channels. I probably have about 7 or 8 YouTube channels. Obviously, Peak Time Racing is my main one. I have a tech channel that has over 50,000 subscribers. So I do know a lot about YouTube, and it's I just absolutely love YouTube. You guys, I'm addicted to it. I watch so many YouTube videos, even when I'm not filming videos and stuff like that. I love YouTube, probably just as much as you guys do. I know lots of you guys love YouTube as well. All right, let's get into my Hot Wheels studio tour. We'll flip it around. We'll start actually on this side right here. I showed you guys these on my last week's video. These are some Hot Wheels lamps that I got, and they're really cool because got these little display things that you can display Hot Wheels on. So it's really, really nice. And there's also a Peak Time Racing Edition one. So if you guys want to get one of those, you can. I've linked everything that I'm going to talk about in the video today down below. So if you guys like these, you want to pick them up or anything like that, then you guys can check them out. So there we go. Peak Time Racing lamps. This is just a little storage area and stuff like that. Nothing too exciting. Let's go around here. Let's start on this side right here, guys. All right. So obviously you guys have seen this quite often. This is my big Hot Wheels track right here. It is the Hot Wheels 6-lane raceway. So here we go. So here's our regular six-lane raceway that we've got. And then it is connected to the extension pieces, which go all the way down right here. Let's talk about something that I get asked a lot is, if you guys notice when I do races, like here, let's go ahead, we'll put, this is actually a Matchbox car. We'll go ahead and put that on. You see how my thing goes automatically? There we go. So a lot of people ask me, how do I use my starting line? It's actually just a piece of fish wire connected to like this little plastic ring. So all I do is just grab that right down there and just go boom, just like that. And that's how I start my races without having to put my finger on here and start them just like that. So it makes it a little bit easier, looks a little bit cleaner. And so that's kind of how I start my track. My track is raised. Probably not the best of ways. I use a little Hot Wheels box here to raise it. I've got weights here to keep it all stable. I raised it up with track pieces right here with weights to keep it down. And same thing right here, so we kind of even it all out. And then down the finish line, you can see down right here, we've got the ending piece right here. The ending piece is done in these custom and ending track where it just sits right here. This is another question I get asked a lot. Is a lot of people ask me, where did I get my ending finish piece right here? And all then these little stopper pieces right here. They were actually sent to me by 3D Botmaker. He's another Hot Wheels YouTuber. He used to do all these 3D printed pieces and stuff like that. You can even see there's a track connector piece to hold the lanes together. So he used to do that. And he'd actually stopped doing that now. So unfortunately, you can't buy them anymore. I don't think he sells them anymore. I checked his website the other day. I didn't really see them. So unfortunately, you can't get them anymore. So sorry, guys. I know a lot of you guys have been asking that. But anyways, so I've got weights here just to kind of hold this all together because the cars do come in and slam in really long or really hard right here. Then we've got these little foam pieces, which I kind of use to just put like the winning cars and stuff like that. It looks a little bit cleaner. The ending, you can see in some of my videos, I do always have these cars just sitting here. These are actually 1 in 32 scale cars. And, or no, one are the 1 in 36? 1 in 36 or 1 in 32? I can't remember. McLaren F1 GTR. My favorite car ever, McLaren F1. These are just ones that I bought, and I just kind of bought my favorite ones. I use a couple of Lamborghinis here just to keep the track together. No big deal. But anyways, all right, let's move on to the displays. So I do have these plastic displays. You guys can see I've got lots of those. I got some on the other side of the room over here too. We'll show you those in a second. But we use those as just to kind of display the Hot Wheels. I'll link those again down below, so if you guys want to pick them up. They're actually double-sided, but we've got, here, let me see here. So you can see that they're double-sided. So if you want to store in behind here, you can store cars in behind here. But otherwise, they look really cool as display. They fit Hot Wheels perfectly. So it's a really cool thing to display. You can see my Bugattis, which all of you guys I know love. There's a Koenigsegg right there. Got Lamborghinis and stuff like that. So I kind of just put my favorite cars in these. And we've got different ones over here. We've got McLarens, Ferraris, and you can see there's some cars missing because, well, we do races all the time, so I've got a lot of cars out here that we've used for races, and right there. Where do I get the Peak Time Racing lamps? Check the link in the description. I might not have linked the exact PTR version of it, this one right here that we're talking about, but I'll find the link for it. I'll post it after this video is done. All right, and what's next? Next, so I've got a display right here. This is actually a window right behind here, which I've covered up with my old Hot Wheels logo. I've never updated this. This is my classic Peak Time Racing logo, big display right there. It's mostly because I've got it covered up now, so I don't really see it, so we don't really need to update that. We've got a couple of six-lane raceway tracks. This box is actually empty because this is the one that I'm using. And this box is a brand new one, which I'm probably going to replace mine with that brand new one pretty soon, because if you actually look at my track right here, you can see it's starting to get worn out. So I think it's time we replace the old one with a new one. So we'll open up that new one sometime pretty soon here. So we'll use that. This is the Hot Wheels display case right here, which I've got for my filming setup, which we'll go over that in a second. What else do we have right here? This is a little thing that a Peak Timer actually made and sent me. So very, very cool. Very, very cool. This is the Hot Wheels GoPro edition set. So this is what Mattel sent me. Oh, okay, so there we go. Cars are dropping. They didn't actually send me a camera. They sent me a little picture of the camera, but it's the whole GoPro setup in here for the... Okay, now this is going to fall here. All right, now it's just leaning. For the zoom-in car. They sent me that little zoom-in car. I'll put that back up here. We'll fix that later on. Of course, it wouldn't be a video unless I dropped some stuff, but there we go. All right, so we've got that there. We've got a bunch of stuff up top. I've got a bunch of 1 in 18 scale cars. I used to collect a lot of these 1 in 18 scale cars. As you can see, a bunch of them up there and a bunch of them all right here on my display. So you can see There's some McLaren F1s, Ford GT, Lamborghini, Mercedes, Bugatti Devo, Bugatti Chiron, McLaren F1, LaFerrari right there. Lots of cool cars that I collected for 1 in 18. So I love 1 in 18 scale cars too, as much as I do Hot Wheels. So we've got a bunch of those all around. What else can we go over on this side here before we move on? This is a little remote control car. It's a Ferrari 458 Special Aperta. And it's electric. PTR Cup, we used to do a lot of videos with the PTR Cup. I haven't really used this much lately, but we still got it on display because, hey, why not? It looks really cool. All right, so let's go over to this side here before we continue on here and we get to the other stuff. So this right here is my actual filming setup. So you guys have seen this display a lot. So what I've done to build this is actually a piece of board. This is actually part of board. You know what? I'm going to turn the light on here so you guys can see a little bit better. So we've got a piece of board, and then I've screwed this together with this board right here to kind of make a little display. And then I've put a sticker on top, like a 3M wrap sticker, which I've used as my background, which is kind of getting worn out. There's a little bit of holes and stuff like that. I might have to replace that soon, but for now it looks still pretty cool. So you guys have seen this display a lot in the background. I changed the cars up in here a lot. These are all, I believe these are all the 2020 release cars in there. So we got a bunch of them in there, all the new for 2020 cars. We've got them all all inside of there. Random Koenigsegg Agera R just sitting right here. We'll move this over so you guys can see what I've got up top right here. I've got a lot of collectible cars up top. Actually, you know what? Let's turn the light on here so we can see those a little bit better as well here. We'll put that over. We've got my big softbox lights you can see right here, which I have to use, which they're kind of big. They kind of get in the way. Let's move those around just for a second here. So I've got a bunch of different cars and stuff like that, ones that I collect. Lots of Koenigsegg Agera's. I actually love those. There's the Golf McLaren F1. What else do we have right here? My favorite Hot Wheels car of 2020. Hard to say, probably McLaren Speedtail or the Audi R8 Spider. Koenigsegg's still pretty nice, but there's so many good ones. It's hard to say. This is something I just picked up the other day, actually. I saw this. It's a Mini GT Corvette C8, but look at how cool that looks. Doesn't that look awesome? Such, like, highly detailed. I think we're going to open that one up. We've got a couple other different cars here. Super Treasure Hunt Teslas, LaFerrari, Enzo F50, 599. We've got a bunch of Bugattis up here. I know you guys love the Bugattis. You guys know how much I like them, so we've got a bunch of Bugattis right here, all in their little Protecto packs and stuff like that. So a bunch of different cars. This is actually the only, I found this in one of my videos, guys. If you guys looked at one of my peg hunting videos, I found this car in store in a Walmart. It's the Ultimate Treasure Hunt. That was about 2 years ago that I found this one. But it's actually the only only Super Treasure Hunt I've actually found in store. Then would you even consider this a Super Treasure Hunt? It's kind of an Ultimate Treasure Hunt. That's the only one I've ever found in store. I have really bad luck at finding them in store, obviously. Hot Wheels ID car, I got that in one of my cases. McLaren F1 GTR, decades, 90s one. So these are all just kind of cars that I keep inside as part of my collection. I don't show them very much, but that's kind of like my favorites and stuff like that. All right, let's kind of back up here and you guys can see kind of this whole area that I use for filming. And you might notice this area right here. So I've actually got two separate areas for filming. And that's because I actually run a tech channel as well. So you guys can see I just recently unboxed the Xbox Series X right there. That's my new system. I actually have a double YouTube channel. So this is something really cool that I just recently did. This is an overhead light, which really helps with the lighting down here. So what I've done is I've put this overhead light on a swing so I can swing it over to this side. And then I just move my softbox lights. And then I've got the perfect lighting for my tech channel right there. So a lot of people don't know that, but that's kind of what I do. That's my other thing. I've got another tech channel. So we do videos on that. So I've got my double display right here. So it's pretty cool. I thought it was actually pretty funny. When I actually bought this, I actually thought I was gonna mount this on the wall, just like right here. You can see the bad cording and stuff like that. But then I realized that, hey, it swings. I can put it in the middle and I can swing it back and forth. So I'm super proud of myself that I figured out how to do that. All right, anyways, let's move this stuff out of the way here. You guys can see my camera stuff. My main camera that I use from Hot Wheels, this is a Canon 80D with the microphone and stuff like that. That's what I use for filming. And then I've got a dual camera set up here for my tech stuff. I use Canon M6 Mark IIs because I film my tech stuff, I film in 4K. I haven't switched to 4K for Hot Wheels stuff yet. Possibly in the future, we'll switch to 4K filming for Hot Wheels and Peak Time Racing. All right, let's go over some more on this side. So we've got, this is actually really cool. These are a bunch of Hot Wheels prototypes and stuff that I have. You can see these are Koenigseggs. Those are not Hot Wheels. Those are, what are those, Mini GT or something? I can't remember the exact ones they're from. But I've got a bunch of Hot Wheels stuff. These are mostly prototypes. So you can see right here, this is an unfinished McLaren F1 GTR prototype. These are all unfinished prototypes right here. This is a custom one made by a fan that they sent me. A bunch of Lamborghini prototypes and stuff like that. Tarmac Works, yeah, you're right, Tarmac Works. Those are what those Bugattis are, thanks. Somebody made me this as well, they sent me this. It's an actual Peak Time Racing Edition 240Z. That's really cool, that's got my original Peak Time Racing logo on there, so that's really neat, they sent me that. More prototypes and stuff like that that I've got right here. A couple other different cars, what do we have up here? LaFerrari, Datsun, there's a McLaren F1 GTR, Bugatti, all that stuff all in there. The name of my tech channel is called Furious Technology. And this is some more cars that I've got up here. I've got a bunch of different ones up here. So besides our 1 in 18 Ferraris, we've got a bunch of different Tarmac Works. What do we got here? We got Tamika cars, a bunch of different ones that I've up here. I've opened these ones up mostly on my channel before, so you guys have seen them. Got a bunch of different Hot Wheels, Corvettes, Vipers, and all that good stuff all in there as well. Just a bunch of other mixtures. This is like my bin of my favorite cars that I've collected that I'm not gonna open. I'll actually open them up and show you a couple of different ones in here that we have. So we've got another Koenigsegg Agera, another Golf McLaren. You can see how much I absolutely love these cars. I've got a bunch of different ones. None of them are for sale. They're just ones that are going in my collection just because I love them. I've got an unopened Koenigsegg Agera R Need for Speed, quite a valuable car. Another one that I really like, the McLaren F1 GTR. This is the Nick Mason edition. This is another one that's quite valuable. And another one that I have not opened up as well, it's the Bugatti Veyron Speed Machines. Another one that's really valuable, and I've actually got one of those that are open, so you can see all those ones I've got that are open, but you can see I've got doubles of those ones. So we use those ones for racing. You guys have seen those a lot. And then we got, what else do we have in here? We got a bunch of stuff in here. There's a Datsun 50 favorites car. We've got, there we go, McLaren F1 GTR Speed Machines one. So if you guys know Speed Machine series, they're very, very valuable. Yes, I have the 6x6 and Matchbox, got lots of those. More Speed Machines I've got in here. These are some Zamac Edition 720S and P1s. You guys know how much I like McLarens, Ferraris, exotics for the main part. So I've got a bunch of different ones. More McLaren 720S, Zamac Editions. I'm a little bit of a hoarder of cars that I like. So you can see I've got a lot of the ones that I like in here. Cars of the Decades ones, I've got several of these that came out when I bought, when those first came out. So lots of different McLaren F1s, Ferraris, and stuff like that all in there. I'll put those back afterwards. So we got tons of those ones, which is really, really cool. Do you have Forza Horizon 4 Edition Lamborghini Veneno? Yes, I do. That's the yellow one. I can show you that one, actually. It's somewhere here. It's part of my... it's somewhere here. I've got it up here somewhere. I do have it. All right, so let's go over back onto this side here. Got a bunch of different tracks and stuff that have opened up. Some of them that I bought recently that were supposed to mix in. Hot Wheels mystery cars back there. The other thing that I do, which a lot of people may know and may not know, is I'm actually a streamer as well. So this is my whole streaming setup right here. Let's turn this on so it looks a little bit brighter here. So most of you guys don't know, I actually stream video games. I stream them on Facebook. So this is my whole streaming setup. You see my new Xbox Series X that I've got. I've got my whole gaming screens and all that. And I think it's pretty cool because I can sit down right here and I can stream. I've got my camera and all that. But then I can still look at all my Hot Wheels collection. So there we go. So there we go. Guys, if you want to follow my streaming, I actually stream only on Facebook now. I put the link in the description box below. It's just PTR Gaming. So I have a PTR Gaming YouTube channel, but I exclusively stream on Facebook now. So if you guys want to catch me on streams, I'm actually streaming tonight. So if you guys want to catch me on stream tonight, you can come chat with me on there. So this is my big streaming setup. I put a link in the description if you guys want to know all the stuff that I use for my streaming setup. And this is my brand new chair that I just got, which I'm super proud about. I love this chair, Secret Lab chair. I'm a golfer, so I've got a bunch of my golf clubs and stuff all locked in behind here just because it's wintertime and, you know, well, we can't golf in the wintertime. Another thing which you guys might have noticed right here, which is really cool, which I recently got, this is a little mini fridge. So I've got a little Gatorade in here. So when I'm streaming, I can actually have a little fridge beside me. And I put this little Hot Wheels logo on here because it had the branding of the actual fridge on there. So I covered that up. So that's really cool. So we got that on there. I've got security cameras. I'm not going to show you much more of that. But I'm pretty high in security to protect myself, my collection and stuff like that. So I've got cameras all over my house and outside of my house to protect me. Just in case any of you guys want to try and break in and steal my Hot Wheels, don't take my Hot Wheels. But there we go. So we've got lots of different stuff all right there. My track, my filming setup. I'm going to go back here just to give you a little bit of an overview. So we've got my filming stuff for Hot Wheels, my filming stuff for tech. I've got my gaming section right there. And then we've got our racetrack and Hot Wheels collection. I haven't really talked about these bins. These are bins that I store a lot of my Hot Wheels in. So I've tried to organize them as much as I can. Like these ones have got Audis and Lotuses, Cadillacs in here, Nissan Datsun, stuff like that. So I've kind of organized them all in there. These bins are super awesome. I probably need to get more of them because I'm kind of running out of room. You can see tons of Hot Wheels everywhere. A bunch of Hot Wheels premiums that I've got set up for a race coming up right here. These are all cars that just fell down. Lots of stuff coming up for those. What else? Open floor. If you guys have any questions and stuff like that, let me know for questions. 6x6. Yes, lots of you guys asking about the 6x6. So here we go. We've got a bunch of 6x6. Someone just said red 6x6. There you go. There's the red 6x6. I love the Matchbox Mercedes 6x6 is my favorite Hot Wheels car. I absolutely love it. Let's switch back around here. Sorry, let me just go back to the questions right here. So we have any other questions here. What's my most expensive car? My most expensive car is probably that Bugatti, the Bugatti Veyron Speed Machines. Where is it? This is probably my most valuable car. I don't really collect like super high-end expensive cars, like the RLC cars and stuff like that. But that's still probably my most valuable, and it's probably worth a couple $100. How old am I? I'm in my 30s. Do you have the gold 6x6? Yes, I do. Thanks for responding, no problem. Gold 6x6 right here. There you go. Got the gold 6x6. I tried to get all the colors of the 6x6. There's actually a new one that just came out. What is your video game? The game that I stream the most is actually a golf game, PGA Tour 2K21. So if you're into golf, come watch me. If you're not into golf, well, you can still come in and say hi to me on my streams right here. All right, let's see. A couple other questions here we got. How's it going, everyone? Welcome to the stream. Guys, if you're just joining in, make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Any other questions about my studio? Where's my IQ cars? My ID cars. I've actually got the collection of all the ID cars up here. I've taken them all out. I put them actually up here right now. Where are my ID cars? Yeah, I've got all my ID cars up here. I don't know why I took them out. I used to have a nicer looking display of my ID cards right there, but I didn't put them, I moved them. What's my gaming channel? My gaming channel is actually on on Facebook, PTR Gaming. So I've got a pretty good following on there. So if you guys want to come watch me game again, go follow me on Facebook, PTR Gaming. I put the link in the description down below, and I'll be going live tonight as well, just a reminder. Let's see, some other questions we got right here. Do you have any very old Hot Wheels? The oldest Hot Wheel I have is let's see if I can find it here. This is probably the oldest Hot Wheels I have. It's this one right here. It's a Rolls-Royce Hot Wheels Redline one. So I've got it in this little display case right here. That's probably the oldest one I have. It's probably, I don't know the actual age of it. It might be 1970s or 80s. I don't really collect super old stuff. GTR. No, can you do one all Ferrari race? All right, fine. One all Ferrari race. All right. Ferrari FXX, Ferrari 458 Italia. We got the F12. Let's see what other ones. 599XX. All right, let's put these up here. We'll do one Ferrari race, guys. One Ferrari race, just because that was requested here. Hold up. One Ferrari race. All right, we need two more Ferraris here. What else do we got? Let's see here. We got the Ferrari California. Oh, let's put that up. Ferrari California. And, you know, we got to do a Ferrari LaFerrari, which is not up there. Where's my LaFerraris? I feel like my LaFerraris are all over here. Here we go. LaFerrari. There we go. All right. One Ferrari waste for you guys. Okay. There we go. All right. Ready? So we got 599XX, F12, 458 Italia. We've got the California FXX and LaFerrari. We'll use my little star to go. On your mark. Get set. Go. Oh, FXX. Is it? No, it wasn't. It was the F12. That takes one. There you go. There's one Ferrari race, guys. All right. Any other questions? We got questions, guys. Open chat. Any other questions? We'll flip the camera around here, guys. Again, if you're just joining in, this is my Hot Wheels studio tour. A bunch of stuff that we've gone over. I've linked everything in the description down below if you guys want to check out all the different stuff. My rarest Hot Wheels car? I would say it's probably the prototypes that I have that are quite rare. But as far as a single Hot Wheels car that's rare, it's really hard to say. It might be that oldest one that I have. That's probably rare. I would say one that's pretty hard to find as far as I have that's new is the McLaren F1 GTR, the Nick Mason edition F1 GTR. This one is quite rare. Let's see some other questions. I mainly collect a lot of the mainline stuff. I'm not like super into collecting expensive cars, because I want to show you guys the cars. I like to be realistic. A lot of people watch me and they want to see the main lines. They want to see new cars that come out. I'm not the type of person that, like, there's other YouTubers that go and collect extremely rare RLC cars that you're never going to be able to buy. Is that, like, it's cool, yes, but I want to be able to collect and show cars that you guys are able to buy and cars that will show up in store eventually. Maybe I do get them sometimes earlier than you guys, but for the most part, you guys could collect all the cars that I show on my channel. So I want to be a realistic collector, and I want to display cars that realistically you guys can buy and not cars that are one-offs or super rare, super valuable. Yeah, that's basically it. Let's see here. Kia versus GoPro. No. My B case, lots of people are wondering, where's my 2021 B case video? I haven't got the 2021 B case. There's a big delay, obviously, because of what's going on in the world right now. The cases for Hot Wheels have been delayed, so I haven't got my 2021 B case yet. There's a few other YouTubers that have got them, but yeah, I haven't got mine yet. My real name is Phil. Can I see my kids? My kids aren't home right now. Matchbox C8, I do not have yet. Do you have Kroger exclusives? I get some of them, not all of them. Let's see here. Fastest car, the fastest car right now down the track is, as I drop one, Kia Stinger GT in the gray. That's our fastest car down the track. All right, some more questions here. Bugatti Devo, you want to see the Bugatti Devo? All right, this is the Matchbox Bugatti Devo. There it is. My favorite Hot Wheels car. I got to go with my favorite. Sorry. My favorite Hot Wheels car. Yes, sorry. This is a given. My favorite Hot Wheels car I've got right here. This is a Lamborghini Murcielago SV from the Hot Wheels Speed Machine series. So like I showed you my rare Bugatti and McLaren F1 GTR. This is just my favorite. Yellow's my favorite color. I love the SV Lamborghinis, the Murcielago SV, the Aventador SV. This one is just my favorite Hot Wheels car. Obviously, I do love McLaren F1s. So McLaren F1 GTR, another one of my favorite Hot Wheels castings. And you can see I tried to take the paint off of this one to try and make it all black, and I didn't make it look very well. But there's the other side of it. So F1 GTR, that's up there as well. All right, some more questions here, guys, before we get going. A couple other questions here. I don't know why you keep saying GTR. Do you have made in India Hot Wheels? I probably do have a few. I don't know specifically. How many Hot Wheels cars do I have? We went over that at the beginning of the video. I probably have over 10,000. I haven't actually collected. My first car, again, we went over that, 32 Ford Coupe. How about your favorite Viper? My favorite Viper? I love Dodge Vipers. Hard to say which one's my exact favorite of those. Can you race your black Bugatti? No, not right now. Sorry. Okay, hold on. We're going to go all the way down. Do you love JDMs? Yes. My golf, my handicap, my golf handicap. I'm about a 12 golf handicap. I'm not very good. Let's see what else. Couple other questions here we got. Have you ever tried peg hunting at thrift store? I have 3 Hot Wheels Sesto Elementos. I don't go to any thrift stores. I go to dollar stores and find them, but not really thrift stores to find any. That's pretty cool that you found some good ones there. A couple other questions before we get going. Jada models, I do have a few of them in my collection, not ones that I show. ID cars, let's see here. A couple other questions here. We're not going to do any races, I think. We'll stick off the races today. But I'm going to do another live stream during the week this week, and we're going to do another Hot Wheels live racing. So stay tuned for that, guys. Two more questions here. My favorite bone shaker, it's got to be the Hot Wheels the Ultimate Treasure Hunt one, the one that I found in store. That's my favorite bone shaker, just because it means a lot, because I haven't found any supers, but I found the Ultimate. And What else do we have? Do I have Lego? I do have a few Lego stuff. Most valuable casting. It's hard to put a price on my exact most valuable one. Where do you buy Hot Wheels in India? I wish I knew. Let's see here. One more question here. Two more questions. What is the brand of those white shelves? These white shelves are actually custom made. My father-in-law actually built them for me. They're just wood, like, I don't know, 2x6s or 2x4s. I'm not sure the exact measurement of them, but they're just custom made and custom painted. They're actually super easy to build. So if you guys want to build your own shelving, you guys can do something like that. It's not very difficult to do. One more question. One more question here. Favorite race series that I've done? Ah, man. My favorite race series that I've done. I love the Lamborghini races. What can I say? Lamborghini races are fun to do and you guys seem to love them. So there you go. My dream car, McLaren F1. A super extremely dream car, which I'll probably never be able to afford. All right, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up. Quick reminder again. Everything we talked about in the video as far as my shelving and the track and stuff like that, you guys can check out the link below. Make sure you guys go follow me on my Facebook gaming page. I'm a big gamer. You can see my whole gaming setup, which I was showing you guys before. So if you guys want to come watch me game stream, make sure you guys come do that. PTR Gaming on Facebook. And that's going to wrap it up, guys. If you have any more questions, when this video is done, it's going to go live. Make sure you answer put those questions in the comment section down below, and I'll do my best to answer those for you guys. You guys, happy holidays. Stay safe, and we'll see you guys back soon. Bye-bye.